Christmas 9 years ago.
Then,
9 years ago.
The voice was far away. I couldn't understand what it was saying. But I could hear one. It was pretty high. Probably a little kid. Huh? No, it was several. Hmm. I hear five. Or six, maybe more. Where? Where are they coming from? I pressed my ear to the wall and tried to listen through it. No, that's not it. Left. It's coming from under the bed? I hauled on the metal frame and flipped the thing over.
This is just the same story he told us before, right?
It was.
Seems like it.
The bed had hidden an air vent under. The hole in the wall was covered by a metal grate. I dropped flat on the floor and peered through the grate. I couldn't see shit, but I knew it in my gut. This was where those voices were coming from.
I just want to say that oldest dude's facial expressions are amazing throughout the entire game.
Also, he just has a perpetual bulge.
Even the vein?
Yeah.
Hold on. Why are there kids here? But then what my inside man told me popped into my head.
Tonight, a ship is set to take the children to a large passenger liner docked offshore.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Am I on that ship? It didn't matter. All I knew was I had to get to those kids. I checked out the metal grate. Did I fit? I stuck my fingers in and grabbed it. And then...
It's an unfortunate audio-visual pairing right there.
Yeah.
Toilet intensifies.
Yeah. How do you like that, you son of a bitch?
I don't think you should talk to your toilet like that. It's a little messed up.
Finally got the damn thing off.
He's just in this, he's just sitting on the toilet like, yeah, eat it, bitch.
Yeah, you like it when I shit in your face. Like, I don't
sweat
really
dripping down my face, so I wiped it off and crawled inside.
Was that important?
The first bit or so was tight. I had a wriggle on my belly.
Yeah, this is his short version. Is like, my brow was sweaty. Mom's spaghetti.
Hands and knees. Puts the whole thing in like a fucking limerick, just for no reason.
I went from crawling like a worm in dirt to skittering like a bug. Couldn't say it was much better, but I'd take what I could get. And when I'd been in the thing long enough to start wondering where it'd take me... A massive sound nearly scared the piss out of me. It was like a heavy metal door had just been slammed shut.
Listen, you should have gone before we got back in the car. You were on a toilet a second ago.
Then, there was a voice.
Furnace?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Yep, there we go.
What? I wasn't sure what it meant, but anything with incinerator is bad news.
Do they have like a law against that? Can you not burn living people anymore in an incinerator? Like, there's some kind of, like, post-Holocaust law that you can't burn live people in an incinerator anymore.
I don't understand where you're going.
I'm just wondering if, because...
You can't murder people, period.
Well, no, but I'm saying, like, I wonder if there's some kind of... Because this is technically in international waters. But is there, like, some kind of world... Like, has the world come to an agreement that, like, hey, that Holocaust thing was bad. Any tools meant to, like... any tools that were used during the Holocaust are just, like, completely illegal... Like, any methods to kill Jewish people?
I mean, I don't know how international waters work in general, but I imagine murdering people's generally illegal
well,
no matter
Keith,
what.
You fill the ocean with water, you sail a boat on it, and now it's international because there's no country there.
I understand what international waters are. I'm saying I don't really know how they work legally, specifically.
That's the thing,
but
they don't work legally.
But I think it comes down more to, like, tariffs and nonsense and not, like... the question of whether or not murder is okay now.
Well, Geneva Convention exists. I think
always not okay.
Well, if you fight a war in international water, there are still, like, conventions you have to follow even if you're in international waters.
But this isn't war. So murder's not okay,
I'm just
period.
Saying, laws still apply in an overarching sense. Like, the UN still has
that
laws
was my
that apply.
Point. That was my point. I was saying, I'm pretty sure murder's always not okay. Well, and going off coast a little bit makes murder okay now, really.
I mean, that's what they say in the movies.
Whenever they talk about international waters, they're usually talking about, like, this is no one's jurisdiction, so our drugs are going to be super safe and stuff. It's more
Except
or less where
pirates. No one ever thinks about pirates, man. Like, they're just like, international waters, freedom. And it's like, yeah, but what about pirates?
We have to keep going. We have zero expertise to rely on for this conversation, and it's just words.
But we have pirates.
Then, almost as if that was a cue, I heard a mess of young-sounding voices. A bunch of straight-up screaming in terror. And all the sounds together made a howl that made the hair on my neck stand straight up.
Mommy, I hate fire!
Isn't that the response most people would have when an incinerator goes off close to the... Yeah, like, an incinerator, like, closes the door and says, like, 18 minutes, you're gonna burn. It's like, oh, okay, well, thanks for letting me know. Like, you're just like, no!
What a polite announcer of my demise.
Like, the kid's like, thanks, I need to know how much time was left.
You're taking this very well.
Yeah.
Damn it. What the hell is going on here? I scrambled through the duct as fast as I could. I made a giant racket, but I didn't care at that point. I soon found a metal door on the left side of the duct.
You scare the incinerator.
Screaming on the other side. I found it. I yanked the handle and threw the door open. I almost ripped the metal off its hinges. What the hell is this place? I couldn't believe what I saw. The room had a dome up top. Had to be about 9 walls, all the same size. Up in the ceiling was an upside-down funnel, almost like a chimney. I looked down. There they were, the kids I'd been searching for.
There's a snake.
There's snake. There's Santa, and there's June.
That could be June and Santa.
And there's Lotus, his kid, because it looks
like
Lotus.
Yeah, that could be Lotus's kid.
It looks like Lotus.
Yeah, that's probably...
No, it was Lotus.
No.
Lotus 7 is just literally ancient. It's been around forever.
He's the old father. Yeah, it's probably Snake, June, Santa, and Lotus's kid, Nona.
Well, she had two. She had Nona and...
I thought we specifically had a reference to Nona, though. Like, 7 knew the name or something like that.
Yeah, it was probably Nona. The other one was in the other room.
For the moment, from surprise and fear. Scared of the room or me, I couldn't tell. Probably both, actually.
Also, isn't that what June was wearing in the flashback?
Yeah.
Not like I can blame them running into a mug like this when they're already scared shitless.
Maybe it's her kid.
Jesus. Yeah, she's already a great-grandmother at the age of 22.
I mean, she was also about to be incinerated on a boat.
Anything
is possible in this world, apparently.
No, that does... Those two things don't even vaguely change the outcomes of the other.
Medieval people lived in a time where you could be burnt by the stake, or you could have children at 14.
I had a near-death experience, and suddenly I was a great-great-grandmother. I don't know how it happened.
Is that a movie?
It's no.
Benjamin Button?
No, because nothing you're saying makes sense. You're just saying words.
I snorted in my own dig at myself and turned to the kids.
Holy shit, your inner monologue is so detailed.
He's sitting here snorting in front of kids? Like, they're impressionable.
I didn't realize how binary amnesia was. Like, you go, you just go full amnesia to, like, anti-amnesia. Now you have every memory ever, down to, like, jokes you had about yourself 9 years ago in your inner monologue.
Don't worry, kids, I'm not your enemy. I'm one of the good guys. All of them stood there, frozen.
Well... They're about to get thawed. They're about to get thawed in this horrible incinerator.
Were they frozen by Ice 9?
Oh my god.
Well, except one. He was a boy, slightly older than the others, in a private school uniform.
Who the hell are you?
He stepped forward and glared at me suspiciously.
I don't want to make any accusations, but a kid with all white hair and kind of looks like a piece of shit. It might it might be Santa. I don't want to make guesses, though, but I think it might be Santa. I just have this hunch.
I'm a detective. I'm here to rescue you. It looked like they relaxed some the second I got the words out.
How are you going to help us?
Where's the exit?
There isn't one. The doors we came in through won't open, and the door over there...
He kind of cut himself off. I think he was considering something before he changed his mind.
Anyway, there's no point. We can't all get out of here. If we don't get out of here, we're going to be burned to death.
How did you get in here in the first place?
Through the door?
The nine door?
The door we got in through last time. There's just an incinerator door.
Which just requires nine, which you just walked in with.
Well, I wonder what the numbers are right now. Ed, I don't know. We don't know why they're stuck.
Can't you hear it? That voice said the incinerator's going to start up soon.
18 minutes.
So.
Like, that's a long time.
The voice spoke again.
Incineration will begin in 15 minutes.
There's still plenty of time.
15 minutes. I look back down at the kids. Looks like a good 20 or 30 feet to the floor. No way I could pull them up. Too big of a distance for any of us to reach. What the hell was I gonna do?
Stand on the shoulders.
Tie all their jackets together and make a rope.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Yeah,
that's a really good idea.
I'm an ideas man.
What about the girls, though? The girls don't have jackets. You can't suggest these poor, innocent children get naked.
June might have a jacket on. She might have a white shirt under that. The other one I can't tell. It looks like a little blouse thing over a shirt. I don't know. There's gotta be scraps of shit around here somewhere.
Then I got an idea.
It's an incinerator.
Wait right there. I'm gonna be right back.
What?
Oh, the bed sheets.
Where is he going?
How long was his crawl?
Approximately 8, 7, 6, 5, 3 minutes.
Did you have to do math to get from 18 to 15?
Yes.
Well, his crawl wasn't 3 minutes because he was already crawling for a long time before the actual 3 minute countdown, the time limit started. That's what happened when he's in the tunnel. So we don't know how long it was, just that it was more than 3 minutes at the very least.
I like how this person doesn't have a name.
He has to do it twice now, which means he has to go back. Yeah, there's a blank spot. He has to go back and forth, which means there's a minimum of 6 minutes, but more likely something closer to 10 minutes, which means he'll have 5 minutes left to then try to.
Well, 5 minutes to pull up, like, what, kids that weigh at max, like, 60 pounds?
But he also has to make the rope out of the bed sheets.
No, he doesn't. He just has to throw the bed sheets down and hold on to one end.
No, the bed sheets are not 30 feet long.
How are you going to make bed sheets 30 feet long?
You tear them into... Have you never watched anything? Have you never seen this trope of a bed sheet?
No, because the ropes are always made. They just tie other bed sheets together. I've never seen them actually take, like, one bed sheet and be like, all right, strips of...
Have you ever noticed how all the knots are, like, close together? And it's because it's a bunch of strips of bed sheet that are tied together. They tear up the bed sheet, then tie the pieces together to make the rope.
That seems very unstable.
It's not a great option, no.
Okay.
But the whole point is you don't have a rope. That's the entire premise of the problem of needing to make a bedsheet rope.
Maybe a noose would be better.
Just tie well. What the fuck?
Because, like, you can...
Why would a noose be better?
Because they're children, so they can fit around it, and you can just hoist them up.
They're light. Children are great at just holding on to shit. They don't weigh anything yet. It's easy. They just grab a thing and you pull them up.
You would have to rely on them to hold on to something. They're stupid. Children are incredibly
stupid.
They've
had years of training on the jungle gym. They've been training for this moment all their lives.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, they're fucking nine years of existence.
It's their Spartan Cliff moment where they can either qualify or they die. I'm just more confused about why they're not just going through the door, but we don't know what the situation is.
Are you just going to leave us here?
They just got frightened again. I'm not the best at that kind of thing, but I tried to reassure them with a smile. Don't worry, all right? I'll be back, I promise. So just stay calm and wait right there. Got it? I didn't wait to hear them respond. There wasn't time. I had to hurry.
How did he turn around? That's impressive.
He just...
As fast as a guy could on his hands and knees.
Just press down A.
Back to my cell. Still no way out of there, but I had a plan. I needed something from the room.
The toilet.
When I got it, I dove back into the hole and took off towards the incinerator. Then. Sorry to keep you waiting, guys.
Did he close the door?
I guess so.
He should open it again.
Well, if the incinerator went off.
And dropped down the rope I brought with me. Back in the cell, I'd torn the bed sheets into strips and tied them together to make a rope.
Oh.
It was sloppy, but it got the job done.
How long did that take? Look how many knots there are.
He was just doing it while he crawled.
What? This is the most talented man I've ever seen in a video game.
I mean, he's a I mean, Seven is the best character. We all have agreed to this already.
Is he a fucking JoJo character? What the fuck?
He does look like a JoJo character.
He's behaving like a JoJo character. It's like,
I planned ahead for this.
Little do you know.
All right, just tie that around yourself, okay? I'll pull you up one at a time.
See? Kids are too stupid to rely.
That's so much more time consuming.
No, it's not. They weigh nothing. He pulls it like it's fish for the fishing line. Just
And they're somehow gonna fit past him through this vent. Like, that's, whoa. Because he could just fall. And then there's nothing holding the rope up there.
Something was off. There were more of you before. Where'd the rest of you go?
Were there? I only saw four.
The boy in the uniform answered.
I let them go on ahead. We opened the number 9 door and they left.
What? You're telling me you opened that door?
That's what I said.
Then what the hell are you doing here?
We couldn't go with them.
I'm really the number one thing that makes it really clear that that's Santa is that they added voice acting, and it's the same voice actor.
Yeah.
Why not?
Look, the only people who can go through the numbered door...
He was in the middle of explaining.
Wait, you opened the fucking 9 door for other people?
Incineration will begin in 5 minutes.
Well, he got back and forth pretty fast.
Well, no, he got back and forth the exact amount of time you said. 10 minutes.
Yeah, which means that it took him... If we're, like, charitable, we could say that maybe the crawl was, like, 4 minutes long.
And then he tied all those ropes together and then went through again.
In 2 minutes?
Yeah.
Because the round trip would be 8 minutes then.
Yeah, so he just...
Fuck. Santa's Superman.
Seven?
Yeah.
Santa apparently is an idiot.
I'll never stop mixing up all the... There's three separate dudes that have S names for the nickname. Like, we could have not fucked this up more.
Well, it's a little bit easier in Japanese.
Just get us out of here!
Right! I grabbed onto the rope. First one I pulled up was a girl with a ponytail. Next was a girl with a red necktie. Boy in a jacket came after. He said he'd climb up on his own. The boy in the uniform at the last up. Like the other kid, he climbed up the rope himself. He looked pretty scrawny, but I guess he was stronger than he looked.
So now we have this further contradicts what happened with the gun. We have two separate occurrences of Santa insisting that nobody gets left behind, which just makes me further think that some kind of blackmailing is happening between him and Ace to cause the gun scene to happen. Because if he was selfish like that, he wouldn't have gotten the rest of the group together to get through the door.
Yeah.
And then here also he lets everybody else go first. So the gun thing contradicts that, which means it's likely that something else is going on.
Yeah, but why would Santa get blackmailed when he literally is Zero who set this whole thing up?
Yeah, that also gets more confusing.
Like,
unless he's not Zero? Like, he's more.
Then who? Seven is Zero?
I don't know. Santa's the person we're most convinced is Zero, but that's changed a lot over the course of things. I think at one point we thought Snake was Zero.
Just because he disappeared. I didn't think Snake was Zero.
We thought a lot of people were Zero.
I think everyone's Zero.
June could be Zero.
She was also there.
Yeah. Well, I don't think Zero ran the Nonary Games 9 years ago.
Well, I'm saying that she seems like not somebody who would be like, oh yeah, I'll just keep getting taken hostage. This is fun.
Well, we have reason to think that Santa and June are in on this because they both apparently have magically a different number. Remember?
Yeah.
Which is like, you can't do that without being complicit. Otherwise, you'd be like, the game doesn't work, what the fuck? And you blow up and die.
We heard some knocking. Everyone looked at the door. It had a thick, square window set into it. On the other side, an angry face was staring in.
God damn it! What's going on here?
Oh, gee, what's wrong with your eye?
Ace? Have you taken your medicine?
Why is the room empty? Where the hell are those fucking kids?
He's mad that the kids aren't all gonna burn to death?
Well, no, he's mad because that shouldn't be how it works.
The door opened, and a man stepped in looking half mad with fury. I recognized his face. I saw him many times in photos during my investigation. The man's name was Gintaro Hongo, the CEO of Cradle Pharmaceuticals.
He wears that to the experiment?
It's an interesting costume, I gotta say.
That's just his experiment outfit? I got a fucking trench coat, my mafia hat, and a striped suit.
I'm just wondering if these people are willing to kidnap and murder children, and they even threaten to murder the cop, but then instead of murdering him, they kidnap him and take them with them? Why?
Also, they put him in the room that leads directly to the incinerator via the vents.
Yeah.
Why would you do that?
They didn't tie him up. They didn't just drug him and then leave him there, so he wakes up on the shore uselessly when it's too late or something. Like, he took so long to wake up that the Nonary games are ending. At least, as far as we could guess from before, it seems like the incinerator just goes off at the end or something. Maybe. So it might have been, this might be the end of the 9-hour duration of the Nonary games. So he just woke up. If he woke up on shore, he wouldn't be able to do shit. He's like, oh, well, this is a bust. But instead they brought him with them and then put him in a specific cell he could escape. And I'm like, this is a series of questionable decisions.
Keith, they
said they were willing to kill him, and they are killing children.
They can't hire a brainiac, all right? They spent all their money on a fucking giant, gigantic ship. They don't have any more money left over to hire.
You don't need a brainiac to have a thug that's like, oh, this guy found out about us. He's dead now.
Yeah, you can't hire good help.
Jesus.
All your money went into a giant Titanic duplicate for some reason. Like, you bought a giant Titanic that you only use, like, half of it for.
International waters,
International
Andrew.
Waters, bitch!
Home goes to the boy hanging from the rope.
Yeah!
Wait. Like he was an animal. He lunged for the rope. Hurry!
That'd be funny if just, like, fuck it. Oh, he tied it around himself.
The uniform booked it up the rope.
You son of a bitch! Get back here, you little shit!
15 feet. 10. The second I could reach the kid, I grabbed him.
Who would have guessed that this child murderer would be so unlikable?
I'm surprised he went into an active incinerator.
Yeah, I don't know why he's going in there.
I guess
foreshadowing!
I guess the incinerator won't go on while he's in there?
No, he's probably just like, I got 5 minutes. What could go wrong?
I hauled him up and tossed him into the duct behind me.
And I left the rope down for him.
No!
Okay, is it really that bad? Like,
Hongo had lost it. His face didn't even look human. It was like the bastard pulled off his fake face. It was really a terrifying devil or some kind of damn monster. I quickly reeled in the rope, leaving a furious Hongo yelling at me from the floor.
You fucking bastard! You won't get away with this! How dare you compromise this experiment!
Experiment? What experiment?
Incineration will begin in 1 minute.
Hey, old man! What the hell are you doing? Hurry up!
The boy in the uniform was trying to get my attention. I may have thrown a salute in a raging asshole's face before I closed the door behind me. No point to going back to the cell, so we went down the other direction instead. After about 30 feet, we came across another duct on the left. This one was heading down. Everybody nodded and took turns sliding down it.
Into the garbage disposal.
To a narrow hallway. There was a door on either side. The one on the left was a normal double door.
When they're sliding down, all I can think of is like, you better hope you're not a bad egg.
But the one on the right was familiar. Black and yellow stripes, and a device next to it on the wall. The plate on it read, Incinerator. Incinerator?
Yeah, that's where we were.
It was the girl with the red tie who answered me. We were inside an incinerator?
Yeah, Hongo might still be there. It looks like it's been shut off, though.
We definitely know that's June now.
Wait, what? If he's still in there?
Yeah, that's not good.
That meant we better. We gotta get out of here. Go to the other door. Hurry! The kids started running, and I was close on their heels. On the other side of the door was a large spiral staircase. Run!
Spoiler alert! God, we haven't got here yet.
La 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 la, just hands over ears. Stop spoiling the game. This is the short version. We're gonna be dead in like 5 minutes. I just wanna point that out. We're gonna be super dead like now.
Round, round, round. devil was on the tail.
You just said that Hongo looked stairway like the devil. So he is on your tail.
We passed a couple of landings when the boy.
Yeah, that's not Snake. I don't know what you're fucking talking about.
Something's up. Akane's not catching up to us.
Akane?
My kid sister. The girl with the red necktie.
So now we know they're siblings for sure.
Akane. Akane. That's strange. I didn't remember seeing her name on the list of missing kids.
Hey! Akane!
He kept his hands around his mouth and yelled.
Maybe we outran her.
Going the uniforms, get it to a stop. I stopped too. So did the other two kids. When did we do that?
Well, we passed a couple big rooms on the way here. Maybe she took a rest in one of them?
No, that's impossible.
Sorry, Grandpa. You keep going. I gotta go look for her downstairs.
He turned to go.
Hey, kid, wait! God damn it, I said wait!
I don't think the kid even heard me.
Fuck!
I spun around to the boy in the jacket and the girl with the ponytail.
I'm going after him. You two keep going, all right? You got it?
The girl nodded and ran up the stairs. But the boy...
I'm going with you.
I didn't have time to argue. I just nodded and took off down the stairs. I could hear him following me. We ran all the way to the bottom floor, calling for her. Akane was nowhere to be found.
The story is also slightly weird because one of the people in the story is in the room. And has so far not acknowledged that they are the person in the story. Oh yeah, I remember all of this. It was the most traumatic part of my life.
God damn it, where the hell did she go?
I could tell the kid was frustrated. And then suddenly...
Help me! Somebody help me!
We heard a girl's voice.
Akane!
The boy in the uniform threw open the door and leapt into the hallway by the incinerator. We rushed in after him. I couldn't for the life of me believe what we were seeing. That bastard Hongo had Akane by the arm and was forcing her into the incinerator.
How did he fucking catch up to her?
And how did he get out of the incinerator? How did we split up? And why, like...
Wasn't she in the vent with us?
And it's like, it's surprising Snake isn't, like, keeping track of the kids at all? Or having them go, like, stay in front of him or anything?
Come on, goddammit, move!
Wait, you're gonna burn one kid? Like, at this point, you're just like one of those assholes who puts a peep in a microwave just for the fun of it. Like, just being you get nothing out of
he's
this.
He's just being spiteful at this point.
Yeah.
It's like the part of, what comes to mind is just the part of, Anchorman, where Jack Black just drop kicks his dog off a bridge. And he's like, that dog's gone now. Why? It happened. The end.
She planted her feet squarely on the floor and was struggling to get away. But Hongo was bigger and stronger. She wasn't gonna win.
Akane!
My brother roared with anger and charged toward Hongo.
Help me!
Ah! You're too late, idiot!
Hongo lifted.
Why are you acting like a child?
The air, pure, still fighting him into the incinerator. Before we could even blink, Hongo had leapt through the door after her. We saw him land inside. And then, the door slammed shut. We ran to the door. We did everything we could think of to get the thing open. But...
Fuck! It's no use! The goddamn thing won't move an inch!
Started slamming his fists against the door. He was close to shattering his knuckles with how hard he pounded on it.
Akane! Akane! Are you okay?
You came back!
Her voice was muffled, but all of us could hear the sheer terror in it.
What should I do? I think I'm trapped in here.
Where's Hongo?
He went out the other door!
What?
Warning. Emergency incineration command has been acknowledged. Automatic incineration will take place in 18 minutes.
How salty will this guy be when the incineration fails twice?
Like, all, like, that, all that work to go to escape and go through the vents and go up a spiral staircase just end up running right back to where they started again. So you end up starting over the same timer again.
Well, one person got away.
Yeah. I mean, they can just go through the vent again.
No, they can't. It's probably too high up now.
They just had to slide a bit. Like, just you could just fucking army man your way up there. I don't know what I'm saying, army man, but like that thing where you just like, you know, you push against the vents and you like climb up.
You just gotta shimmy your ass up a vent?
Yeah, or a child will die.
Not my child.
Obviously, he cares more than you do, because he's doing all this shit.
I mean, if he cared more, then he would have been a little bit faster at catching up with Hongo. Also, if Akane cared more about living, she would have bit Hongo's hand, like a reasonable child would do. What?
Indeed. Emergency incineration command has been acknowledged.
Are you fucking kidding me? It's the same damn thing.
Are you there?
Yeah, we're here. Just hang on, all right? We're gonna figure out a way to save you.
His words would have seemed like a sick joke to her if she'd been able to see how white and bloodless his face was right then.
Incineration will begin in 17 minutes.
Please! Please help me! I'm really, really scared! I don't want to die!
Well, how did Hongo open the door?
We don't know. Maybe he's got a bunch of bracelets somehow. Maybe he's just rigged the whole thing so he can just use any door he wants.
You could always just punch the dead.
I mean, Hongo doesn't have a bomb, so he could just, like, do what he wants. Because he's not part of the Nonary game, presumably. Or otherwise, what the fuck?
I don't think these kids have bombs in them.
You don't think they have bombs in them?
No.
You think they're just bracelets and that's it?
Yeah.
Did they have bracelets? They had bracelets.
Yeah, they have bracelets.
They?
I don't think they have bombs, because I think that would be like a little too much. Like, because if you would have to perform surgery on a child, that could
right,
easily
there
be.
There was two Nonary games happening simultaneously, and the only one who died apparently was Connie, supposedly.
Yeah.
I think. Which is this, probably. So yeah, they probably didn't have bombs specifically.
It's gonna be all right. I'll figure something out. I promise. I promise, okay? You hear me?
It was torture listening to her sobbing on the other side of the door. Her brother was nearly crying himself. He could only stand there, fists clenched so tight his knuckles were white.
What happened then?
Come on, man. Put yourself in my shoes. It doesn't end good. Think I want to remember that?
No, but just, you know, just say that.
Yeah.
Instead of trailing off. He's like, yeah, guess what happened? I didn't save her. The end.
Then.
Yeah. Shit. If I'd known it was going to be like this, I almost wish I hadn't remembered.
Anything to say, Snake?
Are you sure?
Huh?
Look, I don't want to ask this either, but there's something I don't get. So if you could just tell me. Did that girl, Akane, really?
Yeah, I'm sure. There wasn't anything we could do. After a while, the countdown ended. And we heard something burning. The fire stopped, but we still didn't move. Me and the jacket kid were frozen. The boy in the uniform collapsed as if he couldn't hold himself up anymore. A few minutes passed. The door opened.
Why?
The boy in the uniform tripped over his own feet running in. We followed, too numb to speak. The air in the incinerator was hot. Every breath made my lungs feel like they were on fire. It was like standing on hot asphalt. The air was wavering and in the middle of the room, there it lay. The kid's legs were shaking so bad, I don't know how he managed to walk. I couldn't see his face, but his body somehow looked empty. Finally, he reached it. He fell to his knees as his legs gave out on him. And then...
I mean...
Can I ask you one more thing?
What's that?
The girl, Akane. What was her last name?
What does it matter to you?
Just tell me, okay? Please?
Kurashiki. Her name was Akane Kurashiki.
Well, he did the thing. The thing?
You were there that day, weren't you?
They just had to go and make that rule about how none of us could freaking, they just had to make that rule about how none of us could talk to each other about who we were.
Yeah.
Boy, would that have fucked with things. Like, oh, hey, it's you. The name of the person who died last... What the fuck?
Yeah.
Oh, were we one of the people that went ahead? Were we there?
No.
Because they let people out that we didn't see. So I'm wondering if that was Junpei.
No, because we would have remembered being in the fucking Nonary game.
Unless we also have amnesia.
We don't.
Because we're dealing with the story. Amnesia's a plot point, which means we're fucked.
The tall kid in the jacket. That was you, wasn't it?
I was talking to Snake.
Yeah.
Yes, it was. You are correct, Detective. Don't misunderstand me. I told you before how Zero threatened me. There was nothing I could do. I couldn't say anything about what happened 9 years ago.
So you're saying you're not working for Zero, right?
Of course not.
Clover, what about you?
Hey, come on! You really think I'm working with Zero? I told you before, you idiot! I was in Nevada, in Building Q. I did hear that a detective rescued the kids on the boat, but I didn't know it was you.
Well, I guess I believe you.
What gave it away? The amnesia?
Another question.
Like...
Santa's real name is Aoi Kurashiki. He's Akane's brother. You know that?
No! No, I didn't. Did you?
Well, yes. I know Aoi Kurashiki was her brother. But I didn't know he was Santa. At least not from the beginning. 9 years ago, he was in the middle of puberty. His voice is entirely different now.
It's really not. Now that voice acting is in this game, I can say it's not that different.
It's different enough for a blind person.
What?
I mean, you're blind. You can't really... You just associate a new sounding voice with a new sounding face. I mean,
but it's like the same voice, but slightly higher.
Yeah, but that still doesn't... That's not like a justifiable say to be like, hey, are you that guy that was in the Nonary game 9 years ago? Like, that's... I don't know. You would have... That's something you'd have to confirm. I think that's a little bit harder. That's a little bit more believable.
But he already has reasonable suspicion because Clover's there, and Ace is there, and Seven is there. So if there's a similar sounding voice, there's a lot of reason to cling on to it. Or maybe two similar sounding voices of two siblings that were in the game with you last time. It's not an unreasonable thing to latch on to.
I'm ashamed to say that even my exceptional hearing wasn't able to make that connection. As such, I had no reason to think Santa was Aoi.
When did you figure it out?
Clover told me that Santa might have been one of the subjects of the initial experiment. It was only a short while ago, while we were leaving the library. When she told me that, I had a... feeling.
Santa is Aoi? Akane Kurashiki, June's brother? There's still a lot we don't know. I mean, like, a lot.
How much more, game?
But there is one thing I think we can say we know.
What's that?
We can get out of here?
Ace is a bad man.
The body we found in the shower room. It had to be Nijisaki, dressed up to look like Snake.
What?
Come on, man. What kind of detective are you? You didn't figure that out already?
Hey, go easy on me, man. I just got my memory back.
Yeah!
Cut me some slack.
What the fuck, Junpei? You talking about how fucking...
So Junpei's point is that of the four people in the photo, it's the only unaccounted for person?
Yeah.
Because we found one of them dead, one of them died in front of us, and the other one's at large. So the one remaining person's got to be the one remaining corpse that was not Snake.
Hmm.
Well, if he is, the three murders make sense then, don't they? Yeah, that's right. Murder. Kubota blew himself up, but that was murder too. So why did these murders take place?
If Junpei is correct, and the body in the shower room was Nijisaki's, that means all of the people who were murdered were involved with the creation of the Nonary Project. Kubota, the person who conducted the actual experiments. Nijisaki, Hongo's assistant. Musashido, the man who financed the project.
You mean this was all just revenge? Santa is Zero. He's getting revenge for the death of his sister.
But she's not
That's
dead.
Why he killed them.
No, I don't think Santa actually murdered anyone. If I'm right, then it's not hard to figure out who the next victim's gonna be, is it? I'm pretty sure I don't have to tell you.
Yes.
Yep.
Right.
The next target will be Gintaro Hongo.
Oh!
Or it'll be all of us if we don't hurry the fuck
Ooh,
up.
Ooh, I thought it was gonna be Lotus.
The person who planned the Nonary project.
In other words, Ace.
Sup.
Yeah. I mean, he does, that face
Ace
is,
intensifies. Fucking vibrating.
What the hell's going on here? It must be 6 a.m. Our time is up. Shit!
What?
We spent it all talking.
What the fuck?
Come on, we need to get out of here.
How?
I'm betting this sucker opens the exit.
Where is the exit?
Let's go.
I tried to warn you guys.